Greetings from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to Space Station Live. It's Friday, September 13th, 2013. You're joining us here inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room, located at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Inside the room right now, the Orbit 2 team currently on console, monitoring the systems and the crew on board the International Space Station. Today, that team is being led by Flight Director Mike Lammers. Joining him at the CAPCOM position, serving as the communication link between the astronauts and the teams on the ground. Two astronauts right now, first of which Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide, a former space flyer on board who flew on Expedition 32 and 33 back in 2012, and also NASA astronaut Katie Coleman, veteran of Expedition 26 and 27 back on 2011. Meanwhile, on board the International Space Station, the crew of Expedition 37, right now being led by Russian cosmonaut Fyodor Yurchikhin, veteran space flyer on his fourth space flight. Joining him from the European Space Agency is Luca Parmitano on his first flight, and then NASA astronaut Karen Nyberg on her second. The major event for the International Space Station crews this week was the landing of the three previous Expedition 36 astronauts and cosmonauts. Having been on board the International Space Station since back in March 28th, two Russian cosmonauts, Pavel Vinogradov and Alexander Mazurkin, and NASA astronaut Chris Cassidy said farewell after spending 166 days in space. Pavel Vinogradov was the Expedition 36 commander and handed over command of the International Space Station back on Monday to fellow Russian cosmonaut Fyodor Yurchikhin. Following that, on Tuesday, he and his two colleagues loaded into their Soyuz craft, preparing to come home. That Soyuz TMA-08M was docked to the Poisk module on the space-facing side of Zvezda. After the hatch closure, they performed a series of leak checks to ensure the integrity of their vehicle before preparing for that eventual undock. Once the hooks holding the craft in place retracted, the springs on the docking mechanism pushed them away, the craft departing and performing a series of separation burns. It eventually landed in Kazakhstan at 9:58 p.m. Central Time, the crew being taken out successfully, all in good health, by the landing and recovery forces. Once out, they were entered into a number of medical tents for some initial medical screening before returning to their home bases, Vinogradov and Mazurkin heading back to the Star City, Russia, where the cosmonauts are headquartered. Chris Cassidy making his way back here to the Johnson Space Center in Texas. Meanwhile, remaining on board the International Space Station, Fyodor Yurchikhin, Luca Parmitano, and Karen Nyberg have been involved in a number of maintenance and experiment activities this week, starting off with Fyodor Yurchikhin, current Expedition 37 commander. Back on Monday, he was helping to prepare a number of samples for return on that Soyuz craft, also taking command of the International Space Station on Monday. On Tuesday, he moved on to drying out a few of the Orlan suits that the Russians wear for their spacewalks, also activating the device on board the International Space Station that enables them to receive telemetry and data from the Soyuz craft while it makes its final descent. On Wednesday, the entire crew enjoyed an off-duty day following a pretty hectic day supporting that undocking and sleep shifting over. Following that, they moved on to resuming all of their work on Thursday as the crew of Expedition 37. Fyodor Yurchikhin was doing some maintenance on the Russian Electron system, one of two systems on board the International Space Station responsible for providing oxygen to the astronauts' breathing atmosphere. He was also continuing some work with the Russian Matryoshka experiment, which is a mannequin-sized doll on board the International Space Station that's used to track and record the dosage of radiation these astronauts are exposed to. However, today, on Friday, Yurchikhin will be doing some more work with some of the EVA equipment in addition to those Orlan suits and photographing them for downlink and study by Russian flight controllers and scientists down on the ground. He'll also be working with the Russian Identification Experiment, which is an ongoing investigation into studying the dynamic loads onto the Russian segment of the International Space Station that takes place during different dynamic operations, such as the undocking that just happened earlier this week, also reboosts. And even the physical exercise by the astronauts on board. This helps to determine any of the microacceleration that some of the very delicate technological experiments are subjected to. Aside from that, he'll be doing some preventative maintenance in the Russian service module, cleaning out some of the ventilation systems. Moving on, European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano, back on Monday, was collecting some blood samples for the human research facility, each of these astronauts serving as kind of guinea pigs for a number of science experiments while on board the International Space Station. He was also preparing the combustion integrated rack on board the station for some experiment work that's been taking place over the last 2 days. That combustion integrated rack, the only combustion research facility on board the station, capable of handling a variety of studies and safeguarding the rest of the station structure from the hazardous materials and reactions taking place on board. Aside from that, on Monday, Parmitano helped set up the robotic workstation that he's been training at alongside Karen Nyberg for the upcoming Cygnus vehicle. Cygnus will be Orbital Sciences' first cargo flight to the International Space Station, taking place next week. Scheduled to launch on September 17th and dock September 22nd, it will be, again, Orbital Sciences' first demonstration of flying the unmanned cargo craft to the International Space Station, bringing the second American commercial provider online. On Tuesday, which was undocking day, Parmitano continued to work getting that combustion integrated rack prepared. Was also in charge of transferring a number of samples over to the Soyuz for return to Earth. One of those samples that he was transferring is from the immuno experiment, which looks to track any of the immune responses in the human crew members during and after their long-term stay at the International Space Station, hoping to provide a better understanding for scientists down here on the ground as they look to develop pharmacological tools to help counter any unwanted immunological side effects that these astronauts can experience during their long-term stay in microgravity. Again, on Wednesday, Parmitano and the rest of the crew off-duty, but on Thursday, he moved right back into some heavy experiment work, working with the InSpace 3 experiment, located inside of the Microgravity Science Glove Box. This is a fairly complex fluid physics experiment, looking at obtaining data on specialized fluids that contain particles that are able to change the physical properties of those fluids when subjected to varying strength magnetic fields. On Earth, such fluids are used in materials that are used for building vibration dampening systems that can be turned on and off with those magnetic fields, having some very important implications in improving the ability to design structures such as bridges and buildings to withstand destructive forces from things like earthquakes. So something happening on a very small scale on board the station having a very large effect for technology down here on Earth. That InSpace 3 experiment conducted yesterday and also continuing on into today. Aside from that, Parmitano continuing to gather some items up for disposal on that Cygnus vehicle that will be making its first flight to the International Space Station next week. Parmitano today, Friday, is involved in some pretty heavy maintenance work. He's working on the station's major constituent analyzer, namely removing and replacing the mass spectrometer device, that mass constituent analyzer known as the MCA, is used on board to provide very critical monitoring of six major atmospheric gases inside of the station atmosphere. Among those, the primary that it looks to track are the oxygen and carbon dioxide levels inside the atmosphere to make sure they're maintained at safe levels, also monitoring the nitrogen partial pressure, which can then be used to monitor the station's internal cabin for any potential air leakage. Aside from that, today, Parmitano, and right now working on some more robotics training for that Cygnus device with Karen Nyberg, the two at the robotic workstation right now inside of the Destiny Laboratory. And speaking of Karen Nyberg, also this week doing a lot of work with that Cygnus vehicle, in preparation for its arrival. Back on Monday, she was with Parmitano working at the robotic workstation as they do some more on-orbit training to prepare for their task of rendezvousing and grapple with the vehicle. She was also returning a few items to the Soyuz for delivery back down to the ground. On Tuesday, though, she was doing some maintenance work on an experiment facility, inspecting some of the samples in the Ice Crystal 2 experiment over in the Japanese experiment module. Ice Crystal 2, examining the growth rate and stability of ice crystals in super cold water. She was also helping Parmitano gather some of those items that will be stored inside of Cygnus, generally trash and other items to be discarded for Cygnus's return. Off duty on Wednesday and moving into Thursday, Nyberg was doing some routine maintenance on board the International Space Station that these astronauts are routinely tasked with. She was inside of the crew quarters cleaning out some of the intake and exhaust ducts, also checking the fan and airflow sensors. It seems like a fairly mundane task, but very important for these astronauts is the microgravity environment not naturally flowing the air, so ensuring that the fans are running and the atmosphere circulating inside the station removes any potential buildup of dangerous carbon dioxide, and ensuring a safe breathing atmosphere again for these astronauts. And then today on Friday, Karen Nyberg continuing some work with that InSpace 3 experiment inside of the Microgravity Sciences glove box. She'll also be analyzing some of the drinking water from these astronauts from the water processor assembly using the Total Organic Carbon Analyzer. And again, checking out some of those Cygnus robotics and also performing a test of the hardware control panel, which will be used to control the vehicle in its final moments on approach to the International Space Station.